Good evening, everyone. Don't know what time it is, but it's going to be good night. My name is Joshua. The surname is as long as that. It's Chaganyuka, born in Zimbabwe. I don't have a story, I got a book, but I'll just give you one page for now. This started, it's not for making you sad, this, but for making you celebrate me. I was born in Zimbabwe. My parents died in 1998 when I relocated to South Africa with my brother years ago. Then it was a story, ups and downs, this and that. And it's actually my first time to be standing in front of people talking about me, about my journey, which is very, very sad, but I'm a superman at the end. So now, 10 years ago, I started working at RRN Removals as a packer in a truck. I know a lot of you knows what removal is. If you want to move your house from here to there, I was the guy who carried the wardrobes and the bed to put in another room for you so that you can sleep safe. So it happens for, I think, 7 years until a man called Desi Naido, who is sitting there at the back, looked at me and he saw something which I didn't see myself. I used to think maybe I'm just gonna be this guy from Zim, where people used to call me Mugabe, who is not a good leader, but everybody's talking about, yeah, this Mugabe guy, but Desi saw something in me. Then he gave me a chance in my life. He told me to stop packing the wardrobes, and he brought me next to him and he said, listen, yeah, this is what you're gonna be doing for me. From that time until today, he's been next to me, not behind me, not in front of me, but next to me to guide me, to show me how the leadership works. So in 2018, 2019, I'm not sure, was too good. But I think in 2019, he made me the manager of RRN Removals. If I look in the history books, there was never a black manager in RRN Removals before, which makes me the first. That makes me the superman, but he's a superhero. So if you look at RRN Removals, people, they wanna see the superheroes in the books and in the on TV, but there's people who are sitting right there who are not on TV, but who are there to make sure that they change our lives so that in next 20 years time, we're going to be sitting that side with more people who are going to be sitting that side where we're going to be sharing them like how they're doing to us. These are the superheroes of our lives. These are the people who must always appreciate, because when I look at my life, I only look at them. I only look on what they did to me. So in, I think it was in March, when they were talking about Rotary Club, there's a program coming. I think Jesse's father, Mr. Naido, is there, senior himself. He told me that I need to join this program. And I'm like, no, man, he's very busy and this and that. But hey, he said I must join. The last day of the application was closed. I think I was the last one to send to carry. Then hours later he accepted me. Yes. What are we gonna do? So I didn't learn or read through about what was happening. So the day when I get the email from carry, then I read through what they sent to me. And I like, okay, I didn't know it was about leadership anyway. Because if I look at my background, I was never been a leader before. I was never a manager before. So I thought it was something for me to learn about life or something else. I didn't know what it was. Then I started reading through the paperwork which Kerry sent to us and started understanding what's happening. And then 23 of October, of April, then we had our first Zoom, 23, I'm not sure. Then I found out that day there was like 20 people in my corner who we're actually doing the same thing. I thought I was alone. Then, but on that 20, Greg can tell you that I'm the one who wants to talk a lot. Which he said, there's people who used to talk a lot. It was one of us. And was me, Curtis, and Evaristo. So I think people used to look at me like I must be a politician because I like to debate things every time. Then I like to ask things. I like to talk about that. I like to talk about this. That's who I am. I think they saw in me. So that it gave me this chance that I can talk, but I thought I was just a talkative guy. But now as I come to leadership program, then I said, no, I talk, but I don't actually lead people. I only talk. So now I find a way that I can actually talk while I'm leading people, because I've never listened to anyone. I must always talk. That was me. I've never listened to anyone. If someone wants to say something to me, I'm stop them quickly, then I start talking myself again. I've never listened to anyone. That's who I am. So everyone who knows me, they know that this guy always talk. But I used to talk with no sense. But now I talk because I've learned a lot in leadership program from Rotary, which they gave us. So the program which you gave us is actually what superhero did to people, to save people. You have saved us from being the bad leaders, because we thought by being a leader must always talk, but not to listen. So now I find a way that I can listen, then talk. But before I talk, I must listen, then it always goes around. So before you talk, you must listen to whatever people want to say first, then you can make decisions due to what people are saying. So when I look at the future I had going with the Rotary Club, is that we're not gonna end here. This is just the beginning of our journey. It's not about talking about our journey, but it's about talking the future. How do we become the part of the future, and what do we change in our communities and organization? So now, if we live here, all of us today, what do we do tomorrow? That is part of the plan. It is not about what we did, but it's about what are we going to do. So if the Rotarians are looking at us, they look at us like, what are we going to do next? So the story is that we do not go and start wasting the knowledge which we gain. It's about starting to get more 20 people in your corner, 20, not to make sure that we take their role. No, you can still come back with them, but we still need to make sure that we get our own 20 people. So by 2600, in 10 years to come, there was going to be 500,000 people who are going to be knowing the same knowledge. That's how we can change the world. So it's about what I've really take on Rotary, also about diversity. So I'm a guy who grew up in Zimbabwe, and as I came to South Africa, things are different. Zimbabwe and South Africa is different countries. So what happened in Zimbabwe does not happen in South Africa. How people were treated in Zimbabwe, how they get being treated in South Africa. So when I look at all of us sitting together like this, if you can, everyone else can sit like that going forward, that is how the world must look like. Because people, they are actually together, but not together. They only sit among each other, but they got different views. So if you can all sit together in different colors, different race, and think the same thing, that is what we're actually looking for. That is how we can build the future going forward, without looking from where you come from, who you are, what color are you. And the next thing, from the leaders who are sitting that side, that in the CVs, they must not say, what race are you? When you're dropping a CV at work, they ask you, what are you? That question, you have to think twice. I'm a human. So that is what we've learned by leadership. That do not look at people by their color of what they are, but you have to look at people on, are you a human? Can you do this? Because everyone who's out there, they're only looking for job, but they're not looking to fit in a color. So if you can give everyone opportunity, like how we give us opportunity, everyone in the world, we can take this world to another level where people can be treated equally. This is what Rotary, I think, taught me. And this is what I can take from now on to make sure that I bring people together, to bring more conversation together, so that we can change lives and change how people get educating their people in the community. That is what I'm actually looking for. So by having Greg and Kerry, it's actually, they talk to me a lot. I used to talk a lot, but when they talk, I listen, because they explain to us in detail on what are we really trying to do. Then the more we listen to them, I become to know a lot of things which I did not know in my life. a lot of things which I can put in at my workplace where I look at Mr. Naidoo, that when they look at me tomorrow, they've known what they put the money into. So let's not give people money, but let's give them education. Let's not give them food, but let them be this type of education which we do not get at school. We do not get this type of education at school where you learn to be a leader. At school, you learn to do math, go and look for work, get money, and get drunk. Nobody even taught us to say, when you get money, what do you do with it? So if you take from this pocket and give someone a chance in life, that is what we're looking for. Not to give us food. We do not need food. We're not hungry. We need education. We need to learn about being a leader. This is what Rota did to us. And we are grateful to have that moment to learn about ourselves, about everything else, about how can we go outside and face the problems in the world without fear. That's how I feel. I got no fear on anything. Thank you so much.